Welcome to the lesson about lines on a coordinate plane. In this lesson, we will understand the fundamentals of lines on a coordinate plane and how we can compare and contrast those lines to help us better understand functions in the future. By definition, recall that a line goes through two points and continues indefinitely in both directions. Now, these two points can be placed on a coordinate plane, essentially putting our line on the coordinate plane as well. Now, our line goes through more than two points, but oftentimes we can define this line by talking about two solid points that the line does go through. Both these lines, even though they only intersect once, both go in opposite directions infinitely, and the only aspect of each of these lines that differs is their slope, or the steepness of a line. Now, these lines could have a very steep slope, a shallow slope, or no slope at all, which would mean the line would basically be flat or horizontal. Now, before we investigate further, let's talk specifically about what slope means as we're referring to lines on a coordinate grid. Now, slope is the ratio of the two distances traveled, specifically a vertical distance and a horizontal distance, as we simply interpret as rise over run. Now, we also think about the y-intercept of a line, and that's where a line crosses the y-axis. So let's look at a simple line and think about both of these things, slope and y-intercept. Now, my line from one set point that I know goes up one spot and then goes over three spots to another solid point that I know. So what is my rise? I went up one unit and I went over three units. So my slope is 1 over 3, which we know as a fraction 1/3. 1/3 is my slope. Now, slopes can be negative if your line has a negative rise over that horizontal distance traveled. Now, a simple way to easily identify if a line is going to have a negative slope is to think, if I have two downward-facing lines and draw two vertical lines on either end, I should get what looks like an N for negative slope. Now let's take a look at some lines and practice by finding slope and finding the y-intercept of various lines. So let's take the line I have here in red, and let's think, what is the slope of this line going to be? Well, I can already take a look at it and know that it's going to be negative of some sort. So let's find two points and make that connection between those two points. We first can find the y-intercept and see that this line crosses my y-axis at 2. So 0, 2. Is my y-intercept. Now, after finding two solid points to use, I can see that my line goes over two units and down one unit. So my rise is -1 and my run is 2. So my slope will be -1/2, which of course we can simply call -1/2. Let's take a look at one more example and one more problem that we want to find the slope and the y-intercept. So taking a close look at this blue line, I can identify my y-intercept being here at 1. So my y-intercept can formally be called 0, 1, or we can just say that it is 1. Now, finding two solid points, I see that I go over 1, and then I go up 4. So I have a rise of 4 and a run of 1. So my slope in this case is 4/1, or we can simply call it 4. That line has a slope of +4. Now, looking at the connection between lines on a coordinate plane, it's important to think about the figures that we'll make on the coordinate plane and future functional relationships.